Okay, today we're going to learn about how to clean the belt on a DVD, CD-ROM player on your computer. Because most of the time, it's just dirty or greasy. And that's why it's not gripping and turning the wheels to open it up. Like this one here, it's not opening. Light will come on, won't push out, just make a bunch of noise. But I'll show you how to make it work. First, you have to know how to get in your computer case. Okay, in the back here, you'll have a screw here, either Phillips head or manually, like the hand ones here we see. Then you'll have one on the bottom, down below. Okay, then you'll just pull your housing off. Now you can see inside the computer. Typically your DVD, CD-ROM, or if you have two of them, they're usually up top. And they're held by Phillips head screws here and here, here and here, here and here. Most of the time, the units like HP or Gateway, different computers, Dell, they'll have sliders on the other side. But you won't be able to get to the sliders, which are just screws like these, but they just slide on the shaft or the rail and they come out. Yours is going to go out this way. All DVD and CD-ROM players and Blu-ray players, they all go out the front. So you don't have to worry about all the cables. Just disconnect the cables, take out the screws, and slide it straight out. You should have no problem. Then we can move on to the next step of tearing it apart and cleaning the belt. The following tools you'll need is a paper clip, a Phillips head screwdriver, and a flathead screwdriver. Okay, once we get it out of the computer, we need to do the manual release. You'll just poke it right through that hole there with the tip of the paper clip. Get the drawer out. Now we have to release three tabs here, here, and here to get this faceplate cover off. Okay, once we got that off, then we can reach the belt. After we get the housing off. So we've got to take these four screws off on the bottom. Some mounting screws left in here, so I have to get these off. But these are typically already taken off. But that's, like I said, for the Hewlett-Packard. Some of them have a slider and chassis where the side that you can't get open is slid in via those bolts. There we go. And you just take the belt off and you're going to wash it with Dawn. Okay, now we're going to wash the belt with Dawn. I have Dawn in this little container here. And what I'm going to do is apply it to the belt thoroughly, rubbing it all around on the belt. And then I'm going to wash it off. Thoroughly wash off the Dawn. And this takes off the oils and whatever else that gets on the belt. Like I said, these belts, they don't go bad. Not very often. So most of the time, you can just clean them and your unit will run like brand new. Once it feels like it's starting to stick to your hand as you're pulling it through, that means it's nice and squeaky clean. Then you'll get a paper towel. Thoroughly dry it before you put it back in the unit. That's a nice and dry belt. And it looks good. There's no pitting, no cracking. It's perfectly fine. And now it has traction. You can feel it. It has traction. It wasn't slippery like it was when we took it out. Now we're back with the belt. We're going to put it inside the unit. Get it to catch. Put it around the other part of the belt. Turn it. Make sure everything's good in there. Everything looks nice and snug there. Okay. Put the top plate back on. Line it up. Start putting the screws back in. Using the Phillips head to put the screws back to the base, all four of them. Two set of slider screws that were on the side. Most of them don't have it. Only if the unit has only an opening on one side of the case. So then you're going to have some slider screws on the side like this one. It just depends on the manufacturer. This came out of an HP. If you build your own, then you know how you put it together. Okay, and you're going to snap your tabs back in. Your faceplate now is snug and secure. Your drawer is in. And all you have to do next is test it. Okay, here's a unit where the door wouldn't open up. You saw me take apart a different one, but that one needed to be cleaned also. That's for another computer. But this one here, this one wasn't opening at all. You'd hit the button, wouldn't open. Well now, opens up clean as a whistle. And I mean, this sucker would not open unless you use the paper clip to manually open it. Now it opens up like a dream. So sometimes you don't need a brand new belt. You just need to clean it. And that's it, folks. I hope you learned something.